Hey guys, that's right, it's Tekken7. I was just in the middle of the stream and I thought I'd just go create a video based on the characters and their outfits. So we'll go into that very soon. Right now, it's the bikini release as well as the Tekken Bowling release. Tekken Bowling, I had a quick look at it. It's very like that. Anyways, guys, we're just going to take a quick look at the outfits. First of all, I'm going to go through the guys, and we'll just have a quick look at what these guys look for, and then we'll go through and have a look at all the ladies afterwards. Right. But basically, this guy's only got the 1920s sort of gear going on. Looks terrible. Looks terrible. Not impressed with that at all. I don't know why they didn't go for the Fundoshi. You'll see that very soon. They didn't have the option in there for him to have it. So yeah. Next up, we've got Brian. Now he did get to have the Fundoshi. So yeah, this thing. Yep. With all his majestic scars, as it were. Right, we're gonna take a look at a quick look at Claudio. This was one of the funniest looks because of his position. I mean, you still wouldn't screw with that guy in a nappy, like. He'll make your day terrible. He'll make your day terrible. But, no. Just no. To that fight. To that body position. Just no. So we'll have a quick look at, Devil Jin. Now, Devil Jin, actually, I gotta say, doesn't look... Well, okay. He looks ridiculous. But the fact of the matter is... It's one of the better looks of the Fundoshi because of the claws and the wings. So, you know, you gotta give him that. Dragunov looks pretty basic. We'll have a quick look at him. Also, guys, if you are wondering why I've got this before everyone else, the fact of the matter is that I've got this because I live in New Zealand. And please don't ever change your date to try and get these things before I do, or like at the same time I do, on your PS4, because you're likely to get banned. And it has happened, and people have told me I got banned from PS4 altogether. So don't do that. So we'll just go through this methodically. It's going to take a little bit of time to do it, but we'll just do it. I was going to edit this and everything and get all flashy, but I don't think that's worth it. We are just going to go through and do this. Cowboy hat. Yeah. Again, Eddie doing his thing. Feng suits this. Down to a T. There's some people who just look like, okay, I train in this. Feng is one of them. That's for sure. Now here's an interesting thing. They did this with Gygas Gigas. And you've got a quick preview there just in the corner, but they actually did it with him. Which is interesting. I guess, you know, having a mainly humanoid form, as it were. I don't mind this. I don't hate it. But, yeah, they did that with him. Heihachi. Well, I mean, Heihachi looks good in it. He's always going to look good in this sort of stuff. He's just such that... He's that traditional warrior. It suits him. This is the look with a Fundoshi. Hwarang. Did I get to Hwarang? Yes, I did. Hwarang. Yeah, looks okay in it. Pardon me while I quickly vape, guys. I'm just doing this video. So, yep. Jack. Now, I tried to change it so it was a little camo. There's only one color that you get in there, but I couldn't get that going right. Looks ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. I mean, that... That's a wedgie. Right? So... Let's have a quick look at what we've got going on further for us. Yeah, not a good choice. Not a good choice. Right, we'll go through this. Pretty much, you can take a good guess of what all this is about, however. Yeah, the hat. I should buy that. Anyways... Looks cool. He does look cool in it. Lars. Looks like you could wreck your day wearing this. You don't make fun of a guy wearing this Fundoshi. Kuma they didn't actually do. They didn't do him. King they did. But as you just quickly got right there. There was something that was seriously wrong with it. Got his tail on point. Could look like a dookie. That's all I'm saying. Kazuya. Oh, Kazuya. Kazuya. Yeah, so he's gonna look good. He's gonna look good. The only way he doesn't look good is if he's in this, you know. But he ain't gonna go around wearing that in a hurry. So, yeah. All right. So we're almost gonna get through to the ladies too. But we're gonna Law, classic character. I changed it to black. There's only one color plan to change. You can only change one color at a time. You know, sort of suits him. It's not a thing. He's very pelvis forward, so it's kind of laughable. But yep, Lee, have a look there. I decided I'd put him in some sort of purple. I have no idea why. I was trying to match his hair, but you know, not too bad. Bounce it up and down. Leo, quick look here. Now they didn't do this with Leo. It's almost very One Piece looking, in fact, because it is a One Piece. So yep. Then we've got, let's have a look. We got Miguel on this one. Miguel, well, he's very pelvis forward too. This Fundoshi thing I like, but I think they missed an opportunity with giving more of the bathing suit stuff options as well. You know, they could have done that with him as well. They didn't do it with Panda, didn't get a thing. Shaheen and Steve, then I'm going to go through Yoshimitsu and Paul and Akuma after this. Akuma, of course, you have to open that up so you already know what that looks like, but I'll show you. Shaheen, see, they did it with him. They did it with Shaheen. They put him in the, they put him in this outfit. And I gotta admit, because it's so 1920s, I don't like it. I'm not a fan of that. Steve, very pelvis forward again. But like just the positioning really where he's standing. So yeah. All right, Yoshimitsu. Show you Yoshimitsu. No, I don't know why they bothered with this one. But he doesn't look too bad. Doesn't look too bad. Yeah, so... Akuma, yeah. Then we'll go through to Paul. Because Akuma obviously trains in it. So, that's the thing. I've actually got to go through, do that mission, and open up the treasure box to get it done. But we'll just have a quick look. Because you know that that's all him. That's how he trains. Then we'll go through to Paul. And then we'll go through to have a look at the ladies. Now, Paul, I couldn't just leave it in white for him. I couldn't, so I had to go with the bright purple. Looks ridiculous. I've never been a fan of his haircut anyway. But let's have a quick look at what else we got here. We're going to go starting with the girls. We'll just start up with Elisa. And have a quick look around. And then we'll go break it all through and down. The bowling thing, it ain't so great. So I'm probably not going to add that in the video. But, yep. So, you know, hey. It's a cute outfit. Like, it's a cute bikini outfit thing they're going on. Asuka. Now, I would have given you both options, but the thing is that I've dressed up the girls in the different options anyway. I don't know why they did this with the plumber crack thing, but seriously, they could have pulled that up a bit further on the hips. But that's a problem with the outfit itself. So, yep, she's got her thing going on. If you notice, she's got man hands. We're going to go through to Josie. Now, Josie looks cool. She does. She looks cool in this outfit. But I'll give you an option to have a look at what's going on with this. Oh, yeah, okay, the schoolgirl thing, that's common for all of them. But, yeah, like, looks alright in either or. Actually, I should have done the schoolgirl thing, the schoolgirl type outfit before. Changing the colors, you can do it in three different layers, or is it four? Anyway, you can change up the stripes. As you can see, she's got a very green outfit going on with it. I kind of like the I don't know why. I think it probably just because I was just going for that green lady painting. That just, I don't know why it reminded me of that, but yeah. All these outfits with the schoolgirl things are all variations on the same thing. Not overly impressed with it all. Katarina, sorry I missed her. I'll just let the outfit speak for itself. That's enough of that. And then we'll go through to Lily. Something very similar here happens too, so I'll let the outfit speak for itself. It's actually the better looking of the outfits for her on that. So I'll just show you the other one. As you can see, that's just all variations on that same thing. But yeah. Yep. Anyways, lucky Chloe. We put her into the golden one. I mean, you can change it up. You could make it all pink. You got different levels of colorization that you can do. Obviously, like you can do with so many of the other characters. But see what I mean? There's three layers of different colors that you can put in there. So I can make it all pink if I wanted to. So. There, go through to here, there, and then we'll go through to as a main sort of puce sort of color thing going on. So yeah, I mean, you can really change it up so that it kind of matches the rest of the outfits that you got going on, and you can also change them, obviously, to do the same thing. No, I'm not going to change that. Yes. Now, Master Raven. Now, I gotta say, no, actually, I'll let the outfit speak for itself. Looks fantastic in it. I couldn't let it speak for itself. Like, I mean, that's a good look. You know, that's a good look. Now, they didn't actually give her the, they didn't actually give her the schoolgirl thing going on. Mainly because, just, you know, doesn't need it. Because that look is incredible. That's actually my favorite of the lot, I must admit. So, but we'll go through to Xiao Yu next, and then we'll go through to Nina last, because I think that's how it works. Anyways, the cute colors that she's got going on with this sort of thing, cute. You know, it is. It's cute. Yeah, there's no other word for it. Cute colors that she's got going on here. I will show you the schoolgirl outfit in it, because she's probably the best representation of what that's supposed to look like. But yeah, we put her on that bikini. But yeah, see, this is, you know, that's how it's supposed to fit, kind of thing. I didn't like her in this one. Thought it was daft. That's why I just went with the cute color thing, on her mane. On her mane there, so yeah, it did look daft. Actually, look, here's something. No, I'm not gonna point it out. I think we got through everyone. I just want to make sure. No, we did. We got through Lucky Chloe as well. So we've got Nina. She's got black hair on this at this point in time. I should have left her blonde. Whatever. Look, here's the thing. Have a look. She totally doesn't need that thing though. We'll give her the default hairstyle. So unsure about thongs with heels though. Weird. I didn't feel this one something that I was overly impressed with. That one was definitely a better look on her. I think in general this is a better look in general, with a more the larger woman, the ones with the muscles, that does tend to look better. And on the smaller, more petite ones, not so much. Alright, so we'll go back out. And I'm gonna go finish on my last on the last one that I really, really like. Alright, we've seen all the girls, we've done this. But I'm gonna leave it with this one, because this, I think, is the best of the lot. Now, what's your opinion? Who did you like? Who did you not like in their outfits? Who do you think could have used, for example, in the males? Could they have used the 1920s bathing suit outfit somewhere else as well? Who knows? And to be honest, who cares when this girl looks this good? I mean, that, like, anyone, she wears this well. She wears this well. Anyway, I'm gonna be out of here. If you haven't already hit that like or subscribe, please do so. I'm gonna be doing this quite a lot with the DLCs on fighting games. Because I'm based in New Zealand, I do get a whole bunch of stuff first. But thank you very much for coming along. You've all been awesome. I'm out of here. My name's Drunken Solitaire. I'm from New Zealand. And as my grandmother used to say, wherever you are, wherever you may be, always let the wind go free. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe.